الرحمن الرحيم. Today we will have case quiz number 112. Case data: 23 years old male, diagnosed with Wagner granulomatosis and renal failure previously. The patient was being treated with endoxan, cyclophosphamide I mean, and corticosteroid. 4 months later, the patient developed a lung infection and was starting on trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole. He underwent a video-assisted thoracoscopy to drain the left pleural effusion. Shortly thereafter, he developed pain in his left knee. The patient underwent debridement of the left knee and a sample of synovial fluid was sent to the microbiology lab for gram stain and culture. Culture grew the same organism. The patient continued with antibiotic treatment at an outside hospital. The patient's knee pain continued and spread to the leg. The patient was afebrile with a white blood cell count of 11.4, slightly elevated white blood cell count. He showed mild renal insufficiency with a creatinine of 1.5 milligram per deciliter. Physical examination revealed a wound on the left knee with necrotic debris in the incision. A sample of tissue from the left knee was sent for culture. The culture grew the same previous organism, as well as Pseudomonas aeruginosa. The susceptibilities of the first organism are shown in the table I will show you after a while. X-ray of the left knee and leg showed advanced tibiofemoral joint space narrowing, knee joint narrowing, but no effusion. Because the patient had a history of lung infection, a CT scan of the chest was also performed. Two pleural-based nodular opacities were noted in the left lung, along with a small amount of pleural fluid. Several small peripheral nodules were present in the right lung. The differential diagnosis of these findings included Wagner granulomatosis and infection, of course. A brain MRI was performed and an area of enhancement with surrounding edema was present in the posterior right temporal lobe. The patient continued treatment with trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole and ceftriaxone was added. The patient had undergone multiple debridements of the left knee and had undergone a brain biopsy. The patient had been hospitalized for almost 2 months while receiving antibiotics. His brain, lung, and soft tissue infections remained relatively unchanged. And this is the susceptibility for the first microorganism seen in this case. The organism was sensitive to amikacin, sulfamethoxazole, sulfa, and trimethoprim, imbenium and clarithromycin, and finally meropenem, and resistant to other antibiotics. So what is the diagnosis? And as usual, we will leave you for 6 days and the answer will be online on next Thursday. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.